Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live in 5 show, where we are living live.
We had a few difficulties yesterday on our first show of the year, so today we are working to make it right.
Sculptures and tries to make a better one, but we will see what that is about.
Is weather good for the Scottish people right now? In America, we'll figure out right now.
The Oakland A's and the Kansas City Royals faced off last night for a wild card spot. I'll tell you who won next.
NASA is expected to give a very nice contract.
And cave-dwelling trash collectors make their way into theaters. That's coming up on today's Entertainment Report.
Stick around.
Why can't I remember this?
No, I should have watched it in your book.
Welcome back.
It's time for the Tetzloff play-by-play. For the Cookie Dough fundraiser, take your forms and money to Mrs. Lopez in room 305 on October 6th. If you wish to bring it in early, please turn them in to her during homeroom.
It's going to be an exciting night. Tomorrow, attend back to school night from 6 to 7:30 p.m. to show your parents your current curriculum and introduce them to your teachers. In every class, parents can feel free examining students' work, how the classroom goes by, and the classroom expectations and standards of this year. That's it for the play-by-play at Tetzloff. We'll be right back after the break.
Hi, would you like to buy a yearbook?
Yeah, sure. How much are they?
$49.
No! Why? No, I would, but I'm trying to save up for a yearbook.
Just do what I'm doing. Go to room 205, sign up to sell 3 boxes of chocolate in the stains, so you get a free yearbook.
I'm gonna go do that right now.
ISIS is spreading and starting to threaten other areas. ISIS is an organization of Muslim terrorists that the U.S. is trying to deal with. ISIS has started to invade Saudi Arabia, Jordan, Lebanon, and Turkey. There are about 1,000 Westerners in Syria fighting, and among them are about 100 Americans.
The Syrian conflict has caused 70,000 Kurds to flee Syria because of the ISIS. The Kurds started to build refuge camps in Syria, and the problem has become worse. The Syrian Kurds have to survive the ISIS attacks on Syria. They are having a rough time trying to survive the ISIS attacks in a refugee camp.
On September 25th, the U.S. launched their airstrikes on 12 ISIS oil factories to destroy the factories. The U.S. used 6 F-15 aircraft. F-15 aircraft are planes that contain bombs and other explosive weapons. They are used for destruction. When the airstrikes hit ISIS territory, 19 ISIS members and 5 civilians were killed. The U.S. aircraft sent out 33 airstrikes, and all of them hit their intended target. The U.S. was joined by their allies, Belgium, the Netherlands, United Arab Emirates, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and Qatar to help destroy the oil factories.
Recently, Scotland had a vote on whether to become an independent country or to still remain part of the United Kingdom. The vote took place on September 18th. The Scottish people who wanted the country's independence, also known as the Yes Voters, wanted to separate from the United Kingdom because they believe there will be better creation and jobs. They want to choose the government they vote for, and they want to stop building nuclear weapons. The No Voters say that separating from the UK can lead to the lack of natural resources, financial issues, and currency confusion. Scotland still remains with the UK because 55.3% of people voted no and 44.7% of people voted yes. The results of the votes really disappointed the yes voters because they thought they would be better off on their own.
NASA is expected to offer a contract to Boeing for going into space together to launch a satellite into space. Previously, NASA has negotiated rides with Boeing for $70 million per seat. Both NASA and Boeing are expected to be traveling in space for 6 months to launch a satellite into orbit under the new contract. They will be traveling in an aircraft to be designed by Boeing with technology integrated by NASA. This aircraft will be able to hold 7 people and will be designed for reuse in order to save resources for future expeditions. Let's see what's going on in the world of entertainment. Good morning, Arnell.
Welcome to the world of Box Trolls. A young orphan is raised by cave-dwelling trash collectors. The young orphan has to save his friends before an exterminator gets them. Follow the orphan that is on a quest to save his friends in the city of Cheese Breeze. Box Trolls came out earlier this week. Let's see what's going on in the world of weather. Good morning, Sammy.
Good morning, Arnell. Okay, it's time for the weather, Tetzlaff Trojans. As you can see in the western side of the United States, California is going to be having some cool weather around the 40s, 60s, and 50s, so it's pretty nice around here. Around our area, it's around 66 degrees, which is pretty cool weather for around here. Now, if we move more to the Midwest, it's going to be a little hotter there compared to the western side of the United States. With Texas being around 79 degrees, moving more north up to North Dakota, it seems to be 54, 57 degrees. So it's going to be pretty cool around there. Now, if we move to the Mideast, it's going to be pretty hot over there compared to the rest of the nation, with Tampa, Florida being around 86 degrees. Move more north to Virginia, it's going to be around 68 degrees. Moving more north to the very top of Maine, it's going to be 52 degrees. So basically, all around the United States, it's going to be pretty cool today. All right, it's time to toss it to Avery. Good morning, Avery.
Good morning, Sammy.
Oh, 5 day forecast. Today's going to be 86 degrees. Tomorrow will be 97 degrees. Friday will be 99 degrees. Saturday will be 100 degrees. And Sunday will be 95 degrees. All right, now it's time for Avery. Good morning, Avery.
Good morning.
Will you please read this? Should textbooks be replaced with iPads? Here's what our viewer said. Yes, because iPads are more convenient. Yes, because it saves paper. We want to hear from you. Hashtag it to the Live in 5 poll or email us. Or email us at Live in 5 poll or email us at webpoll at liveinfiveshow.com. And if it's good, we'll read it on the air. So Carrie, what do you think?
I think iPads would be a good idea because we wouldn't have to carry as many books and fall and make fun of ourselves.
I agree. So now let's send it over to Christian with sports.
In soccer, Paris Saint-Germain beat FC Barcelona 3-2 when Abrahamovic was injured and did not play. David Luiz scored one of the goals for Paris Saint-Germain. Messi and Neymar scored the two for Barcelona. Last night, the Kansas City Royals faced the Oakland A's for a wild card playoff spot. Oakland scored 7 runs in the 7th inning and was dominating the Royals, but then they came back in the 8th inning scoring 3 points to tie the game and moving it into the 11th inning. No one scored in the 11th, but next in the 12th, the A's scored a run to take the lead. At the bottom of the inning, the Royals scored a point to tie the game, and later on, Perez grounded the ball to the left along the sideline to bring in Christian Colon, winning the game. Kansas City Royals advances into the wildcard spot in the American League Central. In other sporting news, Angels are the second team in the MLB to clinch their playoff spot and division title. It is their first title since 2009. The Angels shut out the Seattle Mariners 5-0 on September 17th. The Oakland Athletics also lost to the Texas Rangers 6-1 that same night. If the Athletics didn't lose to the Rangers, then the Angels wouldn't have clinched the title and playoff spot. C.J. Wilson pitched 7 shutout innings before Joe Smith and Huston Street pitched the 8th and 9th innings. Angels fans chanted, "Let's go Rangers!" and MVP for Mike Trout. The Los Angeles staff celebrated with champagne and safety goggles on the field. Ray Rice from the Baltimore Ravens was cut by the NFL. TMZ released a video of the encounter. A personal incident happened that led to Ray to a suspension on September 8th. NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell and members of his staff wanted Ray Rice suspended from the Ravens team for his misbehavior. Now tossing it over to the 411.
Today's 411 question is, how long is the Eiffel Tower in meters? 312, 321, 342, or 361? Take 5. The correct answer is 312 meters.
Talk about a late letter. A woman receives a family letter 83 years after it was mailed. The letter was sent in 1931, but apparently it got lost during delivery, and she just recently received it over the summer. The woman explains to her mother and grandmother about her experience teaching at school for 1 year. She also says, quote unquote, the letter gives her memories about ancestors and family, end quote, and says that if they were still alive, they would say, it's about time. That wraps up the Daily Live in 5. We'll see you back here tomorrow. Have a great day, everybody.
Summer.